Take the roof off and welcome to the stage, your next act from Wodonga, it's Tom Newton.
My name's Tom. I just turned 16, which is pretty cool. Got my L's. Been driving around a little bit recently. I just wanted to say, if anyone's been driving around the Albury-Wodonga area lately, I'm sorry. I've probably cut you off or blinded you with my high beams. So, yeah. I seriously, when I'm driving at night, I can't get the hang of the whole high beam, low beam thing. Because when I'm driving, I tend to just sort of drift off into a bit of a trance, you know. Probably not a good idea when you're driving, whatever. So, you know, if I'm driving and someone's coming past me and they're flashing me, trying to let me know that they can't see, I'm always just like, it's kind of weird. Wonder what that was about, you know? Look up in the rearview mirror and there they are just swerving around the road, like crashing into trees and stuff because they can't see, because I blinded them. But driving with my parents, it's always a pretty interesting experience. On one hand, you got my mum, and she's like the most overdramatic passenger ever. You know, a lot of screaming, swearing, crying, that sort of thing. I once counted 23 curse words and 3 near-death experiences, and we'd only driven to the supermarket, so it gets pretty hectic. It's actually quite funny for me because my mum, she's not a religious woman, but my driving has actually made her a religious woman. So a lot of the time she just sits in the passenger seat and just prays in the only way she knows how, which is just, Jesus, 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 you know? And that's a great confidence boost for me, like really. But then you got my dad, and he's what I like to call a kind of passive-aggressive passenger. So he prefers to just sit in the passenger side and quietly judge me while I'm driving. It's just like, okay. Well, I wouldn't have changed gears there, but you know, you do you. It's your life, do what you want, you know? It's like, look, fam, you could maybe say something that might improve my driving or like stop us from crashing, but he just prefers to be salty, doesn't he? Yeah. Hey, Dad. It's gonna be an awkward car trip home. But he's even sassy before we get in the car. Like just the other day, we're about to hop in and go for a drive, and he just looks over at me and he goes, excuse me, if you could just not kill me today, that'd be great. I have a wife and daughter to come home to, so like, yeah, thanks, you know? Speaking of his daughter, possibly my sister, but I'm not convinced. She's actually quite a good ballet dancer, to the point where she's winning quite a bit of prize money now. So that's great, because now my parents love her more. It's actually getting to the point where my mum and dad don't remember my name. Just the other day, my sister and I are chilling out in the lounge room. My mum walks in, she's like, oi! Oh, this is awkward, hey? Yeah. Well, the disappointing one. Can you go do the dishes, please? Lit, I'll be right on that, thank you. You know, and it's getting worse every day. A couple of nights ago, I was chilling out in my room, about to go to sleep. My dad walks in. I got kind of excited, because I thought, maybe he's going to tuck me in, kiss me goodnight, say I love you, son. But no, he just kind of walks over and he's like, we're putting you up for adoption. Walks right on out. So yeah, that one hurt. I mean, on one hand, I sort of understand my parents because I can't compete with my sister, right? The most amount of prize money I've ever won is $8 from a scratchy. So if I were my mum and dad, I'd ignore me too, you know, no hard feelings. But then on the other hand, I sort of feel like they are a little bit hypocritical because I like to think I'm pretty good in most of my classes, pretty good at school. And then you've got my parents, and well, let's just say they named me Tom and they named my sister Meg because they can't spell. You know, gets above 3 letters and get a bit scared, so it's all good. I mean, I don't really blame them, it's not their fault. They are from Frankston. But no, sometimes it is really hard being the less successful older sibling. Because I mean, if you think about it, right, I've been on this planet for more years than she has. So you'd think I'd have my life more figured out than she does, right? But in reality, she's over there winning almost enough prize money to be independent. And here I am, still trying to figure out how many days in a row you can wear the same pair of undies. 9 days. Thank you very much, I'm Tom Newton.
Make some noise for Tom Newton!